another emergency. It's interesting, we've got all these bloody heat wave and bees dying and shit going on. We've got some ladies here stuck in a lavender bush, going quite happy. At least we're next to the ambulance station if it all goes to crap, so we won't have too far to go. And we've got the doctor surgery across there, and a pie and chips just over here, so we're all good. Tell you what, things could be worse. Let's go and see what's happening. So apparently the guys were doing a bit of a clean up here at the kindergarten, and they had them in a working bee, and Mandy sent some of the boys out here to move this bush, and they come back in with a little bit of a fright in their voice, saying, "Not bloody light, we're not moving that bush, there's a nest of bees." So here we are, the bush bee man to the rescue. Let's go and have a look at what's in here. Gee willikers. Oh my goodness me. They've done pretty bloody good, haven't they? They're not very far off the ground, are they? Jiminy. That's a weird place to stop. They've been here for a while too, by the look of that honeycomb. And they're not really angry, they're not attacking me. But I don't think I'm going to be brave enough to cut that up without a bee suit on. And we're kind of getting rid of a bit of traffic. I don't know when the doctor surgery shuts, that's just across the way here. So that'd be great, wouldn't it? Anyway, I guess we haven't got far to go if we end up getting stung to bits. Maybe we better go and get some stuff to put these girls in. And upside to it is at least we don't have to move the bush. Just take the bees and bugger off. I think I better invest in a proper pair of scissors. Well, I guess at least, you know, at least we're at the kindergarten with my kindergarten scissors. Should I go? I think I might go and get my pocket knife. God damn it. I wouldn't get any awards for straight cutting. Whew. I guess at least it's not a wild boar or something that we're trying to skin.
Gosh. If they're in the dry zone. Boom.
Was that rocky thing, wasn't it? When he jumped up on the steps. Some shit like that.
Eye of the tiger.
Oh, that's right, Eye of the tiger. Look at the smoke of the bag. You know, I've got it too long now. One thing I have noticed with this hessian stuff is that actually, once you've used it for a bit, it actually lights up really good next time once it dries out. I don't know, maybe we should invent a pre-done hessian sack for bee smokers. Oh, hang on, I'll just tuck his little tail in. Hopefully they're not too angry when we pull them apart. Oh, deary. Oh. That sent him inside. I reckon I'm just going to see if I can cut around the bits here and see if we can lift it up. If we can lift it up, we'll drop it in the box. So then hopefully the queen doesn't run off into the bushes. Otherwise that'll be crazy, wouldn't it? Well, I don't know. These girls have been fairly enthusiastic, haven't they? What have you been doing? How'd you end up settling here? You have the rat bags. They've done pretty well. They mustn't be too angry because they've been hiding here next to the kindy for a fair while, but look at this lot. So, anyway, we'll find out when we stir them up in a minute. Where are we going to go to here, lad? So I was having this dream last night about doing something like this. And I don't know, we were playing around cutting out these bees like this, and I think they must have been Africanized bees because they went bloody nuts and they all flew up in the air and then they started stinging us to bits and we had to run into the house. And I was trying to get the screen door shut and they were banging on the screen door like you wouldn't believe, and then little trying to sting me through the netting, and I'm like, this is a bit crazy. So hopefully that's not a premonition, because that could be a bit bad. We've got no screen door to go and hide in. We'd have to go and hide in the car. That's just a beekeeper's nightmare anyway, but still, hopefully they don't look too mad. It's kind of incredible that they're obviously all just living inside here somewhere. Hopefully we can lift it up and pop it in the pot. any good suggestions. They're pretty stuck to the floor here. Oh man, check this out. This is really interesting because when you don't normally see this in the hive, but when you're smoking them in the open like this, you see how they all disappear inside? How cool is that? So that's why when you're working on a normal hive and you use your smoker, you can chase the bees around to where you want them to be, or chase them out of the way. So that not only calms them down, sends them where you want them. So that's a pretty cool thing, isn't it?
Oh, there's a bloody great big polar bear coming to our lavender bush, ladies, what the hell? Hey, Margaret, who the f's on guard duty? Get out there. There's a bloody angry polar bear in our backyard.
So I reckon I'm just going to go and get the container and put some gloves on before I lift them up. And we'll pop them in that, and then we'll figure out what we're going to do after that. I don't know. They're a little bit excited here. Well, as you would be.
Rightio, let's see if we can lift them up.
I think I should have got a bigger pot. That's a big nest. So experience has told me that if I start dismantling the nest where it is, then the queen, by the time we get to her, she'll have enough time to just bugger off, and she'll probably end up under the bush here somewhere with a few little soldiers, and they'll all be hiding in the lavender bush going, I don't know, but we're not coming out. We're not coming out for him. And then she'll be sitting there on her throne going, bloody hell, everybody's left but me. So anyway, so we'll put her in the pot, and then hopefully she can just happily be caught with her other buddies. Well, that's the rough plan anyway. We'll see what happens in a minute. My goodness, lasses. You have been busy. Help! There they are. Oh, I think I needed a bigger pot. Pet chicks, what are you doing on the ground? That's a very radical thing to do. Because normally, you know, they're up in a tree where it's safe. I don't know. Anyway, they're obviously doing a reasonable job because there's a bit of weight there, so hopefully there's a bit of nectar. They've probably got a whole heap of cool stuff to get stuck into. And they're not real psycho, so they might be a really good...
Might be a nice little nest.
But actually, the nest was actually pushed into the dirt even. So that's pretty crazy. I wonder if the honeycomb will be like... lavender flavoured since it's in the lavender bush. That'd be something weird, wouldn't it? Where the heck would we start with this mess? God. I guess we just start at the outside like normal, do we? So I'm just going to wriggle it forward a little bit, chop all this crap off, then hopefully the little nest will actually fall into the box. I think I'm going to need to have to get different size boxes for different size madness. God. That'll work. That's good enough. Right. Now, we'll go and see if we can find some rubber bands and see if we can pull this apart. Rightio. Well, I reckon we'll just start dismantling this and see what we can find. Hopefully, see if we can get rid of some of these sticks, but I'm just noticing down the bottom here, the brood's actually down here as well, so they've made a nest right out to the outside, into the ground. Maybe this is a whole new thing. We're not going to be able to save all this stuff because it's so tangled up. Sorry, ladies. You're not happy with me, are you? I have got your best intentions at heart, honestly. I know you're happy here in your lavender bush, all chilled out. But you're about to be... Well, I think the lavender bush was about to be removed, so that wouldn't have done your home any good. Oh, help. What a mess. I wonder if I should put the box over there. Since that's where they're going to. Maybe we'll do that. Confuse the crap out of everybody. What do you reckon? At least they're not angry. That's a good start. Even though we come here after kindy hours and after the doctors are shut and the deli's shut. And so hopefully we can get all this sorted out without anybody getting excited. Except for the bees, of course, they're getting excited. I don't think they're very happy with this arrangement. Oh, golly.
It's me. Where would we go? Where's our layers? They've got stuff going around and around in circles here. Haven't got any really nice layers at all yet.
There will be though, somewhere in here, surely.
Well, they've been getting a nice supply of pollen anyway.
Hey.
I wonder if they know where everything is. They have it all stacked in neat little rows. It's not very neat here though. It's a bit of a bloody, bit of a dog's breakfast, you lot.
Goodness gracious, you lot. You'd get a bloody gig on the hoarders show, you're making such a mess. Nobody knows where anything is.
Way too many little branches everywhere in here.
Get that little bit.
Well, I don't know how those blokes would get on with this nest. They're saying I'm supposed to have everything in the right angle and this angle. These girls have got shit going everywhere. They've got stuff up that way, stuff horizontally. They've got the honey stored in the other bit, in circles almost, going up this way.
And then they go on that way. But they're actually, I don't think they mind which way up they are.
We'll just see what's going on the other side, because nothing too productive this side. Help. Well, if we don't lose the queen amongst all this excitement, it'll be a bloody miracle.
Ain't it? Oh, that looks like it might be a bit better there.
At least there's a little bit there. Got some nice young larvae too. It's good. But we'll try not to wreck all that.
You have definitely made life a little bit complicated for the bush bee man.
It's all go here in the lavender bush.
Struth.
When I saw how close to the ground this was, I thought, oh, this will be a treat. It's not turning out to be that much of a... It's typical bee rescue. It's always a complication. What the hell, girls? What are we going to do with you lot?
Some more sticks here than a witch's broom closet.
Oh, God. I'm just thinking we might just tip these bees that are on the outside of them in our box, so then we can see what we're doing a bit, because...
a bit bloody hard to see. They've got stuff such a tangled mess.
I might be able to see a little bit more then.
So this is the top one, isn't it? It's on the side. Oh God.
There's just like sticks everywhere. Like normally they sort of hang down and they have beautiful big sheets, but these guys have got sheets going this way, sheets going that way, sticks everywhere.
There's a nice little bit of brood here though. This is a bit of a chamber. And a bit down that side, so if we can get there without wrecking stuff, that'll be good.
Here we go, here we go. That's the one. Get that bit off there. Right, chicks. At least there's one nice sheet I can see. I think we might nearly have one frame to put in the box. That's just ridiculous. Why is it? Whenever you think something's going to be actually reasonably easy, it never is. Just like goes crazy.
Nothing is either as simple as you'd think it should be.
Well, a little bit like life though, isn't it? Nothing's quite as easy as you think it should be. I guess that'd be no fun if it was all simple, would it?
This is hopefully we can find something a bit exciting. It's like they've actually built around the corner. Look at that. It's like... it's a corner hive.
It's like when they build those buildings at the end of that intersection, it just has the little corny bit because they had to fit.
Oh, no, no, I've never seen a living nest quite this crazy.
Goodness gracious, girls, what have you done? There's one nice bit down here.
Oh,
it's a nice solid bit of brood there. The jolly sun's going down. I didn't tell the missus that I was going to be late tonight, so this could be interesting.
Oh, anyway.
Anyway, she knows us bloody mad beekeepers are out doing something stupid.
We'll just tip a few more of these, I reckon, before we lose anybody.
Yep. That made a bit of excitement. Well, they weren't upset before, they are now.
That's a bit more like it.
Goodness me. Well, they're starting to congregate to that box already, so I don't know. We'll see. She might already be in there. Hopefully, with that big rattle that we just did a minute ago. I don't think I've ever seen such a messy nest. This is ridiculous.
Crazy. Crazy, I tell you.
Crazy, I've never seen them build around corners before. I mean, that's just bonkers. Because I've obviously just had to build it around the branches that were in the way. And it's bloody unreal. Because normally, like, if you would have seen, they've usually got the nice sheets, which is why they've come up with this idea. The nice sheets of bloody brood. But this has just got shit going every direction. Look at this, we've got one bit going here, and we've got one bit going there, and we've got this one on a round angle. Look at that. All the kept bees are dying of starvation. These chicks out here in the weather. Rocking shit. Rocking it off. Do you reckon maybe we'll just leave the box here? Do you think anybody will notice? We'll throw a branch over its head and store them here. Come collect a bit of Loxton honey. Right, the chances of it being here in a month's time would be a bloody slim, wouldn't it? Well, I suppose it'd be a brave person to nick a bee box. Well, you wouldn't think people would actually nick a beehive, but they do. There's been a few get blooming ripped off around here. I was watching a YouTubey thing about the almond pollination and people were nicking them and re-renting them. That's a bit messed up. Like, God. And then, of course, the poor bloke that owned the bees probably didn't get paid. I'm just looking here, this is just massive honey and sticky muck. So I'm thinking, and we've got a few bees stuck in here, so I'm thinking if I just stand the container up here next to where the entrance is, and hopefully we don't create another nest away from the nest that we want them in. And I'm just going to sit this here, so then the lasers that are all stuck in that honey can walk their way into the hive, get cleaned up by each other. It's kind of fascinating when you watch them clean each other. You see a bee covered in honey and she'll come in and all the other girls will lick her, well, I guess they're licking her clean. Clean her all up and get her all organised and then she can go in and not make a mess. They bloody look after each other. Oh, here I was thinking this was going to be nice and quick and easy. I was all excited when I saw how nice and low to the ground it was. I won't even need to bring a ladder. And now it's actually taken longer than normal. It's seen such entanglement. Oh, I don't know. Anyway, I guess we'll have to come back and have a talk with the kindy kids about bees and what was going on. So the kindy superintendent, would she be the superintendent? Anyway, she's invited us to give a bit of a talk about beekeeping. So we thought, well, we can hardly actually take this blooming box of bees in to show the kids, can we? So we're going to make a little mobile observation hive, I think. So hopefully, by the time we get that organised, that'll be kind of cool. That'll be something different. I'm not exactly sure how we're going to make a blooming small observation hive, but we'll probably have to go buy some stuff, won't we? Because I don't think I've had that laying around the backyard. Obviously, we've got the door open down here where they're running in and out of, but I don't know. I'm just a bit concerned as the field bees all come back. They're used to just landing on this, so I'm hoping that they'll land here. Hopefully the Queen doesn't decide to walk out and do her thing, but anyway, I don't think she will. Anyway, we'll come back in the morning and see what sort of trouble we're in. I wonder what we're doing this morning. Hell, I hope they've all decided to go in the box. Shh. Heck, look how they've clustered up a bit. I think I might go and put my bee suit on though. I don't know that I'm this brave. So we'll get this out of the way for a start. Hopefully we can sweep them in the box. A little bit gentle. Looks like they've made their home. Oh, that doesn't look promising. They're outside bees, I think. They don't know what this getting in a box business is. I'm just wondering whether we pick it up like it is, or maybe we shut it down and actually leave it here and pick it up tonight. I don't know, because this is like they're still out here fairly well and quite a lot. I'm pretty enthusiastic here. This is a serious nest. mm-hmm. Since they've been here established for quite a while, they're a bit freaked out. I reckon we're just going to put the strap on. Well, that sounds a bit rude, doesn't it? But anyway, we're going to put our tie on the lid, and I reckon we'll just leave them here and we'll come back tonight after they've settled down and check them out again then. Because I figure they haven't attacked anybody since they've been living here for a year, so it won't hurt. But anyway, who knows? We'll come back tonight. The box might have buggered off. Here we are again, another sunrise. Ta-da! Hopefully we can get the ladies organised today. It looks a little bit more respectable from here anyway. I don't know.
Are they around the side?
It looks like they're settling back in there. That's cool. So I reckon that's the go. I'm happy with that. But I think I'm a coward, so I'm going to go and put my B-suit on in case. Just in case it does like it did the other day. You remember when I was carrying that box and it fell in half? Oh my God. So I think being, well, hell, if that happens, I don't know what we'll do. We'll just get in the car and bugger off, I think. But anyway, I think I'll suit up and then we'll figure it out. Here we go, Mandy, we'll get rid of your bees. So now your little kindergarten kids can have a bit of smoko in peace. Hello, chicks. Let's get you the hell out of here before everybody wakes up. Is it me? Or did Henrietta let one rip? House is shaking.
That has to be one of the worst jokes you've ever told.
Oh, well, it made sense in my mind. You know, sometimes when it sounds good in your head until it comes out your mouth and then it's too late to put it back in. It's just not fair, is it? I wonder if comedians feel like that on the stage when a joke bombs. They're like, oh, nobody really got that, did they? The really sad part about this show is that the lad won't even edit me out when I'm crap. So he just leaves it on there. Do you reckon we'll make it to the shed without putting our suit on? I reckon we'll be right. Anyway, this could be the last episode if I drop the box, but hopefully not. Welcome to your new home. Sorry you won't have any kindy kids to stir up anymore. They're seriously not sure about being inside. I think they're kind of like a little bit weird ass. Anyway, hopefully they'll settle in here and be quite comfortable. I'm a bit worried that they're still on the front of the box. So maybe they're inside outside bees. Who knows what the hell's going on? Anyway, they'll be a lot safer here than in that bush, so that'll be good.